There's something deadly stalking these tranquil fields, a killer that has already claimed literally billions of victims and could have a devastating effect on the global food supply. Call it the case of the disappearing bees. All over the US, Canada, Brazil, and parts of Europe, bees are simply vanishing from their hives, and no one knows why.
This is very, very typical of what beekeepers were seeing in February.
California farmer John Cox has lost 90% of his honeybees.
Like all farmers, I'd rather have a good year than a bad year, and this one's been about as bad as it gets.
What in the world is going on in this county?
On the other side of the country, University of Delaware entomologist Dewey Caron is one of dozens of scientists working on the problem, trying to find out where the bees have gone.
The bees are simply disappearing. Across the United States, it's affecting as many as a quarter, 25% of the colonies, and so we're talking of over a half a million managed bee colonies that have now died as a result of these particular symptoms.
The silence of the bees is more than an intriguing environmental mystery. It's a multi-billion dollar body blow to global agriculture.
The bees do us humans a big favor. They pollinate about one-third of all the different kinds of foods that we eat free of charge. But now, with the bees in trouble, the food supply could be in trouble too.
Apples, asparagus, and tomatoes, broccoli, cucumbers, and squash, not to mention cherries, oranges, watermelon, and many more. All of these are foods that depend on bees for commercial-scale cultivation. The U.S. Agriculture Department calls the disappearing bees the biggest general threat to our food supply. There's no shortage of theories about what's killing the little creatures. Some unknown new disease, pesticides, genetically modified foods, even cell phone transmissions. But so far, no one's found the smoking gun. Caron thinks it's a cumulative effect.
Formic acid. Formic is very highly corrosive.
Too many diseases, too much human interference in the environment. The bees, he says, are acting like a canary in a coal mine, sending out a warning that even now may have come too late.
So maybe they're trying to tell us something ultimately about our environment, something that's unhealthy for them and maybe ultimately for us too.
Rob Reynolds, Al Jazeera.